What's the headline here? That the U-turn, you're now saying, had to have been done by a pilot, by a person making a decision?
Well, it's a little difficult to explain, so let's take this slowly. Basically, the first turn that this plane took off of its path was done by a computer system on the plane. It was not done manually by a pilot.
What does that tell us? Let me stop you there. What does that tell us?
Now, that computer system can only do that if someone on the plane or someone shortly before the plane took off programmed that into the plane. So that means that whoever did this had to have known what they were doing with the plane. This is not just someone on the plane who grabbed control of it and took it in one direction. Whoever was on that plane that caused this to happen had to have programmed it into the plane, or it could have been programmed in before it ever took off.
So there's no question in your mind, according to your reporting, that the U-turn was deliberate, that this was no accident, that it wasn't some catastrophic event that somehow led the plane to turn. Someone made a decision to turn that aircraft.
Look, it's all very early, so, this is what we know right now, and it could change as we learn more. But basically what this shows is that whoever moved this plane and why it did this turn was because the plane did it itself, but the plane only could have done it if someone had reprogrammed it. And this information was relayed back to the ground before everything was turned off.
Wait, what do you mean by that? What do you mean it was really by a person? A person was communicating it?
No. I'm sorry. I'm talking here about the information that was received on the ground. Information, this came from data that was received on the ground from the plane. Now, that system was turned off around the same time that the transponders were turned off and the plane lost communication with the ground.